Let's try a little experiment. I want you to read the first paragraph of Alice's Adventure in Wonderland out loud. It's a little weird, right? With only a few words per line, it's kind of awkward to read. Words or phrases that might be read as groups end up getting broken across multiple lines, making it hard to parse the sentences. Why don't you try this one instead? It's got a few more words per line, so maybe we won't have the same problem. It's the same content, but with more words, and it still doesn't work. If a line of text is too long, readers get lost when trying to find the next line and end up reading the same thing over and over again. Or they get lazy and might read the first part of each line, but by the end, they're skimming. Over the last century, there's been lots of research done to determine the ideal measure. That's the technical term for the length of a line. I've seen research ranging from 45 characters per line to as many as 90 characters per line, depending on the font used, if it's in print, if it's projected, or on a computer screen. But there seems to be a pretty solid consensus around 65 characters per line for the web. It's not a hard and fast rule, but it's a good place to start. We need to consider the way people read as we create our designs, since it can affect our layout. That's why line length is an important factor to consider as you're building sites, and something I always take into consideration as I choose my breakpoints. It's also important to make sure that fonts are big enough to read across any device. I always set my base font to at least 16 pixels and at least a 1.2 em line height. Depending on the situation, I may even increase it for text-heavy sites. 14 pixels is just too small. That may sound big, but makes for a much better reading experience. Even on a desktop, it works quite well.